Once you determine that your battery is dying or is dead, which battery should you buy? And where should I go buy a battery? Well, with that being said, I did some research and this is what I came up with. Without getting too technical, essentially there's three types of batteries. Number one is a standard flooded battery or wet battery. This is the most common type of battery used in the auto industry. A wet or flooded cell battery operates by means of a liquid electrolyte solution, which is battery acid, covering all the internal parts. Wet cell battery produces a gas, which is hydrogen, when charging. This gas must be able to escape, which is why some refer to this type of battery as a vented cell battery. You can recognize these batteries because typically they have six caps on top of the battery, which you can unscrew and fill distilled water to make sure it's working properly. There are two types of flooded wet cell batteries. They're primarily manufactured for two purposes as shown in this illustration. The one on the right is a deep cycle battery, mainly used for RV and marine purposes. The one on the left is primarily used in the auto industry because of its short bursts of high energy, thinner plates, and more surface area. These types of battery are called SLI batteries. The SLI stands for Starting, Lighting, and Ignition batteries. This type of battery safely provides a great deal of fast bursts of energy. This ability to provide high bursts of energy makes these batteries ideal for starting engines. Number two, the gel cell battery. Gel cell batteries are specialty batteries that typically cost twice as much as a premium wet cell battery. You can recognize these batteries because they have no caps to remove. A gel battery is a valve-regulated lead-acid battery in which a predetermined quantity of electrolyte together with sulfuric acid is combined with silica fumes. This chemical reaction results in an immobile, gel-like mass giving these batteries their name. The gel batteries are virtually maintenance-free as they use one-way open valves to allow the internal gases to recombine into water, hence removing any need to check or top off distilled water or monitor water levels. Gel batteries are extremely robust and versatile. They are safe to be installed in places where ventilation is limited due to the fact that a very low, virtually zero gas fume production, which means you can even install the batteries inside your home. They store very well and do not tend to sulfate or degrade as easily as a wet cell. There's very little chance of hydrogen gas explosion or corrosion when using these batteries. They are the safest lead acid batteries you can use. Keep in mind though, gel cell batteries may require a special charging rate and a special battery charger. Some more common names for the gel cell batteries are sealed regulated valve, dry cell, non-spillable, and valve regulated lead acid batteries. Number three, absorbent glass mat batteries, also known as AGM batteries. AGM technology became popular in the early 1980s as a sealed lead acid battery for military aircraft, vehicles, and UPS to reduce weight and improve reliability. The sulfuric acid is absorbed by a very fine fiberglass mat, making the battery spill-proof. This enables shipment without hazardous material restrictions. The plates can be made to resemble a standard flooded lead acid pack in a rectangular case. They can also be wound into a cylindrical cell. AGM has a low internal resistance, is capable to deliver high currents on demand, and offers a relatively long service life, even when deep cycled. AGM's is maintenance-free, provides good electrical reliability, and is lighter than the flooded acid-type batteries. While regular lead-acid batteries need topping charge every 6 months to prevent the buildup of sulfation, AGM batteries are less prone to sulfation and can sit in storage for longer before a charge becomes necessary. The battery stands up well to low temperatures and has a low self-discharge. Okay, so there's many other types of batteries, but these are the three basic ones, the flooded, the gel, and the AGM batteries. Which one should you choose? Well, they're all pretty good batteries, depending on what you're going to use it for. If you're looking for a low-cost battery that'll do the job, a flooded cell battery will suffice and will do a good job. A gel battery, like I said, is basically for RVs, so you can store your battery or keep it in your home and it won't spill. The AGM battery is the best of two worlds. It provides enough power, and the fact that it won't spill, you can store it in different angles. Remember though, the gel and the AGM battery requires a special battery charger. So keep that in mind when considering buying one of these types of batteries. Okay, so if you're looking for a flooded or a wet cell battery, the Delphi MaxStart will give you the bang for your buck. If you got a little more money, you can go with the AGM batteries. Typically what comes to mind is the Optima batteries, the red top. But if you do your research, you'll find out there's been problems with the Optima battery red tops. Apparently they were bought out by Johnson Controls and currently they're being made in Mexico from what I understand. The better AGM battery that performs really well are the Odyssey batteries. Odyssey batteries are manufactured to strict quality standards in two global factories. Warrensburg, Missouri, USA, and Newport, Wales, United Kingdom. EnerSyst is a global leader in stored energy solutions for automotive, military, and industrial applications. So you can kind of guess which one I'm going to get. But where can you buy these military-grade batteries? Well, I'm sure you can find these online, or you may or may not find them in your big box parts stores. I myself understand doing business with a local community business and understand doing business with these small businesses help boost the local employment. That's why I choose Costless Auto Parts. Anyway, you do your research. You'll find there'll be a lot of options and a lot of prices. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe, and of course hit the bell. Until then, we'll see you at my next video. Bye.